Hello, my name is Josh. This is my story in video format, the workshop portion for the class. My story is titled Party in the USA. This story takes place back when I was around 17, 18 years old. I just joined the band that I am in still to this day. And I think right around when we were 19 years old, we got signed to the label that we are still with, and then we got signed off to a management company shortly after. And right before we signed to the management, we got offered to go on this three and a half week tour. It was like our first real like oh shit moment. Was that, even though like the signing to the label and like the management thing was cool, this was like this is what we wanted to do ever since we like started playing music, was to just travel. And so the tour was Texas, and it went to the West Coast and back. And again, we were like just a little annoying, like shit kids, you know, from the suburbs. So we had never left the suburbs before until that time. And yeah, it was great. We stayed in truck stops and abandoned parking lots. I think at one point we went to a hotel, but not to stay in the hotel, to sleep in the parking lot and to take like as much free stuff as we could and to eat their breakfast if we woke up or stayed up all night, or you know, whatever, like in the morning, like one person would like stay up all night or something, watch the gear, and we would just kind of eat the free breakfast and not stay there at the hotel. And then we'd leave as quick as we could, so we didn't get like in trouble or whatever. And yeah, so we were broke, but we were so like, it just seemed like we felt so free and so like full of adventure and not a care in the world at the same time. As long as we had each other, that's all that mattered. And so once we got to California, the first show on the tour was at the Whiskey. And we were opening for another, like this big band out there. And after the show and everything, it was just so surreal, you know, so surreal playing that and being on that stage. And after the show, we went back to the hotel, like a proper hotel, and stayed. And then the next night, you know, did it all over again, but in another city. I think it was Fresno. And then we went to San Francisco and then San Diego, I believe. I think it might be in a different order, but it was something like that. And yeah, we just kept killing it in every city, man. It was awesome. People would come up to us and, you know, say like how, oh yeah, that set was sick, you know, you know. And some people say like, if your band's like did a good job or whatever, like some people just go up and say, hey, great set, even though they didn't watch the fucking set. But these people actually did watch the fucking set, and it was great. And yeah, there was that one point where we all just kind of started to like hate each other. We were just like, I don't know, like every little thing would bother us. And I remember being at a gas station, like in the middle of fucking nowhere, and Trent, who's the singer, like he like asked me for something. Like it wasn't even like a big deal. Most of the time I'd be like, yeah, whatever. But in that moment, that time, I was like, dude, get the fuck away from me. Like, I don't want to fucking like get away from me. Like, I just like, ah! You know, I just started like screaming at him. And I'm not like an angry guy at all. So anyways, the rest of the tour was like that. Was just like this, like the band was like split into two. My side, Trent's side, and I don't know how it even got to that point. It was just because we just kept seeing each other all the time, and we weren't used to seeing each other that much, and, you know, dealing with money, being angry, and just, you know, you really figure out who that person is, you know, when that person's angry, deal with money, or they're upset, and yeah, it was just different colors of me came out that time. And so when we got back home, and again, we slept through, you know, the truck stops and the parking lots, and we did the hotel thing once, I think, in El Paso. You know, we got back home, and I just looked at him, you know, it took me like 30 hours, fuck, to like think and say this because I was so like stubborn back then. I looked over and I told him, I'm sorry, dude. You know, like, I don't know what came over me. I mean, I just miss my family and I'm not used to this. And, you know, he said the same thing and we all kind of hugged it out, you know. And those are my people, you know. And I guess the moral of the story is, you know, no matter what, your support system, your friends, the people who love you, who really love you, they're around you. Just look around you. You know, don't be too, like, in your head about I'm the shit or whatever, because, you know, you have people that love you that are right around you. They're probably right in front of you. You know. And after that, we went on to tour and play festivals and, like Warped Tour and ACL and for a couple of years until the pandemic, and then, you know, now we're still doing it, but now I'm in school, so I'm very grateful for those guys. I'm very grateful for the opportunities that we were given, and I'm very happy that I was with those guys. I would not trade those guys for the world. I love them.